So we are now at our plate number six. So here at plate number six, we will be mastering the circle command. So here in the figure, you can see a base plate. So first, let's draw this rectangular shape. So we have a 4 and a 5.25. So here, let's create a line. Ortho mode is on. So we have 4. Then we'll have 5.25. Going up, we also have 4. Then we can just enter C to close the figure. So we have a rectangular figure here. Now let's have this slanting line. So we have 2 and 4.25. So that's 1. So let's have an offset. So let's have it 2. We have 2. This one, let's have 1. Okay, let's create a slanting line here. Then let's delete this one. And let's trim. Double enter. Okay, so let's check for the dimension. We have 4. This should be 5.25. This should be 2. This should be 4.25. Okay. So here, going back to our figure, we will be creating our circle. So there are 3 circles in here. Let's first determine the center of our circle. So we have a 1 here. And a 2.5. So let's offset. Let's have this as offset 1. We have this one for another offset. Highlight offset. That's 2.5. Okay. So let's click this circle icon. So there are a lot of options. You can choose, you can input the radius, you can input the diameter or a 2.3 point tangent radius or tangent tangent. So let's just proceed with the diameter. Since we are given the diameter in this figure, it's 1. So if you see this symbol, that's diameter. So click the center. We have to identify the center. Then just input 1, then enter. So you have 1 circle. Now let's have the other. So an offset of a 1.5 and a 3 here. So let's have this one. So 3. Sorry. Offset. 3. Enter. We have that. And this one is 1.5. Okay, so we have this center of our circle. You can also use C for command circle. Then you can choose graph 2. Oops. Let's have it here instead, the diameter. Because we have 2 and 1. So we have, let's have 2, enter. Again, I clicked enter to use the same command. This time we'll have a 1 as the diameter. There you go. So let's delete this construction lines that we created, and let's put the dimension for this circle. So going here to the dimensions, we have a lot of options. Let's just move to diameter. This is the appropriate dimension command that we are going to use. So we have 1 here. So the positioning, let's have that one. We also have, use enter again. We have this one. And also have, I'm clicking enter every time I need to do it again. Here, so let's have the dimensions for your circles, the offset. So it's just the linear one. So make sure that your ortho is on. So clicking here, we have one. Again, enter. This one and this one, we have 2.5. Enter again. So we have the center for this one. So this is 1.5. Clicking enter again. So this one is 3. So again, you already know how to plot. So this is our plate number 6.